Wahawks, today is Wednesday, March 20th, A-Day, and in honor of World Storytelling Day, we will be doing your announcements today in the style of storytelling.
Once upon a time, in a faraway land called Washington, filled with values and magic, there lived a great and powerful King Housie. Housie wanted all his subjects to value learning, and so he sent his head chancellor, Mrs. Morosky, to remind everyone in the kingdom to follow the laws of the kingdom. The subjects would need to wear their IDs with renowned zest and vigor each day. The subjects cheered.
Whilst the celebrating was commencing, one concerned subject asked, "But when must the makeup crew turn in their forms?" One wise old woman told her, "You must be brave and battle through. Your form of committed dates must be turned in to Miss Daly by this Friday, March 22nd. Feel free to bring it down to her room during home base or drop it in her mailbox in the main castle."
The youth was frightened, but decided to make the quest. On her way out of the castle, she was approached by a young elf leaping about. He invited her to join him in his April leap activities, from snakes to magic to virtual reality. She signed her name in the realm of Queen Drosler. The elf smiled and told her she had passed his test. As a reward, he bestowed her with many pieces of silver.
The young heroine of our story was so delighted by this gift because now she had enough money to purchase a yearbook from the court clerk in the castle's main hall. She ventured in and placed her $15 on the head table. The clerk recorded her name in the great book and then wished her well on her journey.
Almost immediately after leaving the main hall, she ran into a very distressed dragon. He had lost his fire-breathing ability and was on the hunt to get it back. Thank goodness the lady was a quick thinker, and before the dragon could attack, she pointed him to the lost and found forest located outside of the land of the guidance, where he found what he had lost and was so grateful that he gave her a ride on his back halfway to her destination.
She said her goodbyes to her goblin friends and made her way to her final destination. She completed her task and was triumphant in her quest. The kingdom was so proud of her accomplishments that they threw a party, and the court band of zeal joined the party at 6:05 p.m. on April 9th to share some great music in front of the castle to welcome incoming fifth grade subjects from 6:15 to 6:30.
At the closing ceremonies, the king made a toast and let everyone know his thought of the day. He said, "Life itself is the most wonderful fairy tale."
Live happily ever after today, Wash. The end.